In the last screencast, we looked at the data Mendel collected and the laws he derived from his data. Remember that Mendel did not know what chromosomes and genes were, but he used inductive reasoning to derive his laws, which are the foundation of modern genetics. Recall from our cell division activity that genes are located on chromosomes. Chromosomes come in pairs, and each chromosome in a pair comes from a different parent. These pairs are called homologous chromosomes and have genes for certain traits, although the form of the gene, called an allele, may be different on each of the homologous chromosomes. We now know that a pea plant has 14 chromosomes, which means it has 7 homologous pairs. Recall that when chromosomes are present in pairs, the cell is called diploid. So here we have a diploid set of chromosomes which are replicated. That is, they have sister chromatids. Remember that a chromosome is always a chromosome, whether it is single or replicated. We can only observe real chromosomes during cell division when they are replicated and denser. If a pea plant's phenotype is homozygous for round seeds, we can denote its genotype with 2 capital R's. The phenotype is the physical or physiological description of a trait, and the genotype is the genetic makeup for that trait. So here the capital R stands for the dominant allele. Now chromatids, before crossing over, will be genetically identical because one was made from the other. So each chromatid will have an uppercase R. The other chromosome in the pair will also have an uppercase R since the cell is homozygous for round seeds. When meiosis occurs, alleles on homologous chromosomes will end up in different gametes. So a gamete has only one of each chromosome, which makes it haploid or N. Each parent will only give one R. Remember that Mendel crossed the round seed plants with wrinkled seed plants. Since wrinkled is recessive to round, we represent the gamete with the wrinkled seeds with the lowercase r. We now represent genetic crosses using Punnett squares. Working after Mendel, Reginald Punnett wrote the first textbook on genetics and used boxes to represent the potential offspring of a genetic cross. In our first example, each parent can pass on only one kind of gamete to the offspring. One parent passes on the round seed trait, and the other parent passes on the wrinkled seed trait. The offspring inside the box, the F1 generation, thus have one of each allele in their genotype, which is big R, small r. Because the round seed trait is dominant to the wrinkled seed trait, we now know that all the offspring shown inside the box will have the phenotype round seeds, but will be heterozygous. Recall the cross of F1 organisms produces the F2 generation. This generation will have one big R on one of its homologs and a small r on the other homolog, which means it is hybrid or heterozygous. This cross is a monohybrid cross. Since each parent is heterozygous, or hybrid for that trait, shown by the gametes on the outside of the box as big R and little r. These letters stand for the products of meiosis. The letters on the top represent the gametes from one parent, and the letters on the side represent the gametes of the other parent. A monohybrid organism will produce gametes that have a 50% chance of having either allele. Inside the box now are 3 possible genotypes: big R, big R, big R, small r, and small r, small r. The recessive trait has reappeared in the F2 generation. These 3 possibilities are shown here. Because the heterozygous condition has 2 possible ways of forming, it represents 50% of the total potential offspring. Thus, the genotype ratio is 1:2:1, or 1/4 homozygous dominant, 2/4 heterozygous, or 1/4 homozygous recessive, or a ratio of three round to one wrinkled. Recall that Mendel's data showed this 3-to-1 ratio. The reappearance of the recessive trait led Mendel to develop his law of segregation.